Hello everyone, I'm CoolGuy, welcome back. About 3 or 4 months ago, I made this video. It was talking about range on a hand cannon and how range doesn't really matter the way that you think that it does. A lot was talked about in that one, the effects of adding to the range stat, the floor and the ceiling as far as meters and falloff, the actual minimal gain that you're getting when you add range to the stat. And really the main goal was to show the player to really think about not dismantling a really good rolled hand cannon just because it didn't hit max range. Part 2 is to elaborate a little bit more on that video, and I'm going to go further into what I mean, and we're going to be talking about aim assist and accuracy a little bit. I specifically didn't talk about those two things in the last video, because the whole purpose, again, was to show what you're getting when you start adding range to the stat bar. And with me, we're going to try to understand the game a little bit more. Now, the beautiful part is that no one's wrong, and with that, no one's right. They're just different views. You go on what you see and what you feel as a player. You test it, and you see what translates. I want to walk through what I feel is going on with range on a hand cannon and why I do value stability in handling a little bit more. And that isn't to say that adding range is a bad thing. Some range is good, it just has a minimal gain. I've played Destiny since it came out, Destiny 1, I'm very interested in the mechanics, and you consider what was said in the past and you apply it to now. Now the only person that can clear all this up is Bungie. Until then, you get a lot of people together and you start to walk through what's going on. So today's my video on what I think. This has a ton of layers, and at the top of the screen and in the description is a link to that range video I made, but here's the cliff note version. It's that when you add on range to a hand cannon, and the two hand cannon used was Ace of Spades that has a range stat of 86, and a green hand cannon, the One Earth, it has a range stat of 35 and it also can roll with at least one perk. And a 35 range stat on a hand cannon is pretty much the lowest you would ever see because they all come with perks. Now, the hand cannon with the 35 range stat hit at 25 meters, then it starts seeing fall off. The ace hit at 28 meters, then it starts seeing fall off. So this green bar right on the screen is all that range in between. There's a total of 51 points on the range bar. When you add range, starting at that low 35 stat, starting at that 25th meter, the gap in between is what you're gaining adding range up to 28 meters. It caps at 28, but more was talked about, such as rangefighter getting past that 28 meter cap or explosive payload. There are exceptions to that rule. But most hand cannons are going to drop right in that 26 meter range off of base anyway. That's not counting Hammerforge, Full Bore, any range adding perks like a Masterwork. They all drop pretty much right at 26, so most of the time, you're just fighting for 2 meters. I wanted to show players that you shouldn't dismantle a great hand cannon roll because it isn't max range. I've seen players scrap Spare and others that didn't have Accurized or Ricochet or Full Bore with a range Masterwork, or they had a Rangefinder but they didn't have any of the range perks, or they had all the range perks and not Rangefinder, and so on. You get very minimal gains going all range, and this is where this video kind of starts. This is to bring in aim assist and accuracy. We're specifically talking about hand cannons, and in the comment section of that video and over the months, I've heard a lot of things, but CoolGuy, what about aim assist and accuracy? When you add range to the stat, you get better hit detection, better aim assist, better accuracy. Or there's more than just that. It's not just fall off with range, it's all these things paired with that. Well, kinda no. Not really in Destiny 2. It all started with Crucible Radio's interview with John Wisniewski, a Sandbox lead designer. That was big for the community. I covered it 3-4 years ago, a lot of us did. We dissected it. He talked about aim assist, accuracy, the accuracy cone. Aim assist is buried within the range stat. The better the range, the further your cone goes out, the better the stickiness is. The hit detection. There's starting initial accuracy, then there's final accuracy. Every gun starts with a tight initial accuracy. After you start firing it, it blooms out. And a direct quote from that interview, he said, "If your range is higher, your aim assist is going to be better." So that's hard stop. This is where knowing what we know then and what we know now and what we feel now starts coming into play. What was one of the main reasons we wanted to know about what he explained? What was happening to our hand cannons? And all of you Destiny 1 players know exactly what that is. It's ghost bullets. And one of my favorite clips of all time, I bring it up again, it's how far we've come as a game. A max range Ice Loon in the background getting repeated ghost bullets. Within that cone, your starting accuracy cone, you could be right on the head, but the bullet would miss. It could happen in a trials game, in a final 1v1, in clash, in skirmish, it happened everywhere. It literally lost you gunfights. You'd be on the head for your final shot, it would miss, and you would actually yell out ghost bullets at the screen. And unfortunately, D2 guys, you might not know this, but D1 veterans, I know you know exactly what I'm talking about. So in that interview, it was actually tangible. We knew, okay, you need to max out the range stat for the hand cannon. This kind of stops ghost bullets from happening more than they do, and that could be felt. The more range that you had, the crispier the shots were. If the range stat didn't have rifled or the range perks, they simply weren't good. You would have more ghost bullets than normal, it would feel awful. As a community, it was then common knowledge. You need range on a hand cannon. If you don't have it, it's gonna fail you more often than not. That was a huge part of Destiny 1, bloom and accuracy. And like I said, there's a lot of layers to this. Let's look at Destiny 2. All you Destiny 1 veterans, from now currently in the game, all the way back to when the damage numbers were changed, meaning the hand cannons became a 3-shot kill instead of a 4-shot kill like they were in Vanilla D2. When is the last time you yelled at the screen, ghost bullets? Really think hard about it. When's the last time you were using a hand cannon, you were directly on the head within range, and your shot missed completely? There are thousands of players, and I'm sure there's gonna be some of you, but for me and most, the shots now hit. And they hit even with a low range stat. It's in my opinion that what we needed range for in Destiny 1 is not the same as Destiny 2. They're two different games, by the way. And what a lot of people are holding on to is from a podcast 3 or 4 years ago. And again, to me, that doesn't really apply to the current Destiny 2 sandbox. The bloom mechanic itself, from what I feel, whatever multiplier was placed on accuracy back in Destiny 1, whatever error angle was used, is significantly different now. If you needed range because there was a lot of bloom, like on a scale, it was a 10 in Destiny 1, it's like a 1 or a 2 in Destiny 2, and I'm gonna walk through it a little bit more in hand cannons. Just like most weapons, they have a floor. A 140 RPM hand cannon like Ostringer here, at a certain point, they hit the floor. The damage number just stays there. For these 140s, it's 24 damage. That could be at 45 meters, could be at 50, it's gonna hit 24, could be at 60 or 70. You could be 100 meters out. No matter the distance, once you hit past that point, it does the floor of 24, no matter what. The same with spare rations, that's a 150 at a certain point, and it's all 150s and all 140s, by the way. At a certain point, it just hits 23s. That 23 hits at 50, 70, it hits at 100. Doesn't matter the range stat on the hand cannon. And back to the Ostringer. When you've seen Ostringer gameplay in this video, it's all on console, it's on Xbox, and it's this one, a max stability roll. It has small bore that adds some range, that's +6. It adds some stability, +6. It has steady rounds, +15 to stability, -5 to range. So that almost negated what small bore gives as far as range. Then a stability masterwork that gives +9 to stability. I value the stability stat. The range stat is pretty much untouched, essentially. The stability stat is up 29 points from base. So it has 92 stability, 53 range. This hits max damage at 26.5 meters. That range, it does 70. Going back, it's severe fall off, and I talked about this in the first video. It'll go from 70 to 65 to 60 to 54. Like, it's really quick. The next thing you look at is a 4-shot distance. Now, for this max stability Ostringer, that's 34 meters. Right there, it does 50 to the head, 4 straight headshots. Let's move to another Ostringer. Range Masterwork, Hammer Forge Rifling, Rangefinder. It has 69 range on the stat bar plus Rangefinder. It hits max damage at 29 meters, and that's because Rangefinder is one of those exceptions to the rule we talked about in the previous video, that with explosive payload, things like that. The 4-shot kill range goes back to right under 37 meters. It does 50 to the head right here. So compared, the Rangefinder one is always gonna have that 2¾, 3 meters over the max stability one. And in game, we've talked about it, coming meter to meter, backing up, very short distance. So here's where I'm getting. Did you notice anything about those 4 shots? Number one, they're out of range, and number two, they hit exactly where I was aiming. So when I started the discussion that range on a hand cannon doesn't really mean what you think it does, it's this. In that video, I said at a certain point, you're simply out of range when using a hand cannon. You're either in range, then you're quickly out of range. There's like no in between. The base fall off is 25 to 28 meters, rangefinder can be added, explosive rounds, as well as artificially with damage dealing perks like kill clip, things like that. But the falloff distance for a 4-shot is right around 37, 38 meters. Past that, you're gonna be in the 40s. And when you start seeing 40s, it's gonna be a 5-shot kill. All of it's very steep, all of it's very sudden. And in Destiny 2 with a 150 RPM hand cannon, when you're 100% accuracy landing a 5-shot kill, that's a 1.6 second TTK. And this is gonna be at about 40, 41 meters. With a 140, you land 5 straight headshots, that's a 1.71 TTK. A pulse, a scout, and even an auto rifle will eat you alive, they will tear you up. The only person you're dueling at 40 meters now with a hand cannon is another hand cannon user, and at that point, it's this weird duel that kind of goes on, and most don't even stay in it, they just adjust and back out. So with this next section, first off, I'm sure that there's a very, very small truth that in Destiny 2, the more range equals the better aim assist, the better accuracy, and so on. but it's in my opinion that it's nowhere near what it was, and I'm firm on that. There's no way it is. Like I said, whatever multiplier they had on Bloom, it's clamped in Destiny 2. That last line of defense, a lot of people hold on to, that thing that was said 4 years ago about Destiny 1, saying that more range is more aim assist, range is more than just fall off. I kind of walked you through these ranges, the floor and the ceiling of adding range, 25 to 28 meters. The entire band that the hand cannons have as a whole collectively on their engagement distance, it's maxed at like 42, 43 meters. Like max. Most of the time, it's like 38, 39. After that, there comes to a point where you hit the floor for the hand cannon class. In Ostringer's case, it's 24. Spares, it's 23. I believe the high impacts are 30. But here at 44 meters, I'm way past my effective range. This is my max stability one. How can I just rip these shots out accurately, spamming the hand cannon time after time? Now, I did miss a headshot, but then again, when you slow it down and look at it, that's supposed to be a body shot because it missed, it hit the body. So when people say, cool guy, you want more range, a max stability roll just won't work because when you add range, it's going to be just crispier at range. Like, are you sure about that? This is a 53 range stat. This is on console, and on console, that's where everything is the worst as far as accuracy and bloom, but this is pretty much the furthest point I should be doing anything with a hand cannon. Like adding 30 points of range on my bar is gonna help my aim assist and accuracy at this distance? Cause we're way past it, we've always been past it. I don't think so, I really don't think so. It's gonna have better fall off, maybe. And again, it's only like 2 meters. How I feel, and let's discuss it, hand cannons are way more accurate than they've ever been. And let's say right here, I landed 8 straight headshots. That's a whopping 3-second time to kill. You wouldn't do that anyway, you'd get tore up. The hand cannons have a very specific range. You're either in range or you're not, as I said in the first video. And when you're way out past their effective range, you're still very, very accurate, regardless of what your range stat is. And when it comes to that range stat, you wouldn't say Thorn isn't good because it has a 54 range stat, or Rose, it has a 44 range stat because they all hit their shots, just like this Ostringer. So the whole adding more aim assist because you're increasing your range, I don't really buy in Destiny 2 with a hand cannon. There's probably a very small truth to it, but nowhere near the weight that it had in Destiny 1. So adding 30 more range to this Ostringer, to me, isn't going to be felt that much, because everything is capped, but adding 30 stability, that can be felt, especially for a console player. And that brings me to the last bit here, the aim assist and accuracy representation in game. And a shout out to Drewski and Mercules. On the screen is Mercules' hypothesis of it all. Again, none of it is stone cold fact, and the only one that can bring light to any of this is Bungie, but this is from fans of the game that dive into the mechanics. A couple of things about this. Number one, adding aim assist widens the accuracy cone, the aim assist cone. And Drewski talked about this in one of his latest videos. There's a link below. I highly encourage you to give that one a look. It's very in-depth talking about accuracy, aim assist, range. It's top-notch stuff. How stability plays into everything. With this, we have this circle right here. That is found to be tied to the aim assist stat. The last word has 40 aim assist and 42 range. Jack Queen King here has 45 range and 96 aim assist. Switching between them, you see that Jack has a wider cone. And aim assist is tied to friction, magnetism, accuracy. Now, next, let's look at 10 paces. It has a 45 range stat, but 76 aim assist. Jack Queen King also has a 45 range stat, but 96 aim assist. Switching between them, both have the same exact range on the stat bar, but the cone widens for the Jack Queen King, because it has a higher aim assist stat. The second thing, coming back, stability decreases the rate at which the aim assist cone shrinks and speeds up the reset. There's a whole lot to talk about with error angles, and a good start, like I said, is to watch Drewski's video. He gets into those things. There's still a lot to learn, there's a lot to uncover. This is a group effort, by the way, and no one is really against each other, we're just all trying to figure it out. And to come back to those little crosshairs is the actual accuracy. So my stance is that when you're looking at a hand cannon, the range stat isn't working like it was in Destiny 1. You can feel the stability added, you can feel the handling added, big chunks like full bore taking away 9 stability and 4 handling. The only thing that you really are gonna feel are the stats that you're taking away. And again, way outside of its range, hitting the floor of 23, 24, it doesn't matter if it had max stability or not, it lands shots. This is the very end, so if I added more range, like the shots aren't getting any more crispier than this. If we look right here, I do have a max range Ancient Gospel. It's a 140, it's got full bore. That's the big one. It has Acarize, it has a range masterwork, and when shooting it, it does hit 28 meters. it hits the ceiling. But the shooting experience here on console is abysmal. Compare that to the max ability Ostringer. It hits max damage a meter and a half less, but it's night and day. So I would rather put my stats into stability, handling, reload, things like that. When they come up, like in a small bore, fine. If my magazine only has high caliber rounds, it gives plus 5 to range, that's fine. When I get a hand cannon, it's perks first, barrels, mag, masterwork next. If I got rapid hit kill clip on a spare rations, I wouldn't care what really else is on there. I would spec it the best that I could. Small bore is great, high cal is great, fluted is great. Because I know that even at a far distance, it's accurate. Sure, it's gonna miss every now and again, but it kinda should. You're way past its effective range. And as far as if you're wondering about cleanups, like do I need max range so that way I'm accurate at a distance to get a cleanup? The first shot accuracy in Destiny 2 is pretty on point with hand cannons for the most part. You could take the lowest range hand cannon in the game, right here, and it still hits the floor, 80 meters, 100 meters, whatever it is. The first shot accuracy is very good, so at most, you would want opening shot to help that out just a little bit. Or explosive payload, that's what I would add. I wouldn't be worried about range. Any accuracy perk is top tier, firmly planted, slide shot, opening shot, eye of the storm, and as far as, again, the first shot accuracy, that's why you can't really test aim assist firing one single shot over and over versus a target, because they literally all do that. Every gun in the game does that. It's when you start getting that accuracy cone back to back to back blooming out and you're way off target, you're not gonna hit those shots then. And that's kind of what's more important. But when you are aiming for the head, those shots do hit. So in conclusion here, I kind of wanted to show again why range doesn't really mean what you think that it does, at least from all of my testing and what I feel. The whole adding range to the stat bar to get crispier shots from what I've seen is a thing of the past. When you're in range with a hand cannon, the shots land, period. The three things I would worry about instead of adding range to the range stat, since all the ranges are really brought in anyway, is number one, the actual aim assist stat. Number two, a big one, accuracy perks. And in the background, there's a small time lapse with 10 paces. It has a base aim assist of 76. It has a range stat of 45. Now the second frame is adding on a targeting adjuster. The aim assist cone widens just a little bit, not very much, but the third part is with a targeting adjuster and enhanced hand cannon targeting on. You can see how that cone widens more and the accuracy crosshairs constrict and really tighten up. And as I went through earlier in the video, you're a lot more accurate with the hand cannons now. So I would worry about things like this than adding 10 more range to the range stat as far as something being quote crispy or not. And perks like slide shot, firmly planted, eye of the storm, opening shot are all top tier. And the third thing is actually what isn't really talked about too much. That's gonna be your connection to host. A shot landing or not, feeling crispy, aim assist, magnetism. Your connection to the host player is a huge part in all of this, but it's something that you can't really test though, even with it being a huge factor. So adding 10 to 15 range on a stat bar isn't gonna help that if you have a poor connection to the host. As far as PC, it's more accurate than console, way more accurate. And for more on all of this, if you want to talk and learn a little bit more, some more theories, I do suggest you check out Drewski's video. He goes in depth into mechanics, he covers PC more too. But basically, when it comes to a hand cannon, all rolls are kind of good. If you farmed a max range roll way back when, it's still good. If you farm a max stability roll now, it's still good. You won't be at a severe disadvantage for doing so, and I think that that was their point all along with these changes. If you're new here, remember to hit the subscribe button. If you are subscribed, thank you so much for your support. If you enjoyed the video, remember to rate it. It helps me out a ton. And one more time, I'm not a developer, obviously. I'm just a player who loves the game. None of this is set in stone. I just go off what I feel and then I test it and these are those results. Thank you for watching, spending a little bit of your day with me. Let's talk about it down in the comment section below. Thank you for watching and until the next one, I am CoolGuy.